Hi, my name's Phillip Slater. I'm the founder of the website at spareparts-knowhow.com and I'm the author of the book, Spare Parts Inventory Management. Today I'd like to take a few minutes to talk about data governance. Now you note that I didn't say data cleansing, I said data governance. And there's a reason for that. You see, no matter what you do in terms of data cleansing, the real key to long-term success is to put in place the correct procedures and policies to ensure the quality of that data going forward. Because without these procedures and without the right software, it's almost inevitable that your data will lose its integrity. Now, sometimes data loses its integrity because two companies merge and they try to merge two databases that aren't really compatible. Sometimes data loses its integrity because a company implements a new ERP system and then they don't spend the time and money required to ensure the integrity of that data. But more often than not, it's because companies haven't put in place the correct procedures and the software required to ensure that they've got good data governance. And isn't that ultimately what it's all about? Because getting this wrong can cost a lot of money. You know, you buy things that you don't need, you might buy the wrong things, so there are procurement issues, the maintenance people may not be able to find the parts that they're looking for, so you end up with extended downtime. If you've got the wrong part on the shelf, you have further downtime issues. There's lots of problems that occur if you don't get this right, so it is super important. So what are the requirements of a good data governance solution? Well, a good starting point is to understand the processes that you have in place now and then decide just what it is that you need to control. Now, care must be taken that you don't design a solution that requires a lot of development, and by that I mean software development and then implementation. So you might just save yourself a lot of time and money by sourcing a solution off the shelf that has the flexibility to map your current processes and then help you configure the software in order to suit your solution already all built in. Then of course there's the complication of having different and separate ERP and computerized maintenance management systems. So whatever solution you choose needs to be able to bridge the gap between whatever other software you're currently using. Now, if you spend the time to source the solution that's right for you in an off-the-shelf software, then you're going to be able to spend your time and energy on the organizational aspects of this task, because it is a big task. And by being able to focus on your own internal and organization and resourcing, you'll be able to get a better solution in place faster. So what's your experience with data governance and implementing assistance for data governance and control? Use the boxes, the comment boxes below, and tell me about your experiences. I'm Phillip Slater, and I'll talk to you again soon.